Although the definition to the tangent line that we just gave in the previous video makes a lot of sense, it's actually not the one that we're going to use most often. And the reason for that is that although this example that we did had a pretty simple limit, in most cases the algebra to simplify the 0 over 0 limit using the x approaches a definition for the slope of the tangent line is just too difficult. We don't want to do it. So how do we make the algebra simpler? Well, what we do is instead of having to factor whatever the x minus a term is out of the top of the equation, we rewrite the equation so that we only have to factor an h out. So how do we do that? Well, this is our point. In this picture, they called it x, but we're going to call it a. This is our point a that we want to find the slope of the tangent line at. So this is our height f of a. And now, the second point, we were calling it x, but instead of actually naming that point, we're going to name the distance between A and our new point. We're going to name that distance h. And the reason that we're going to do that is remember that the slope function is change in y over change in x. And if we want the bottom to be a single thing here, we're going to make our change in x a single letter. We're going to call it h. So if this point's A and this point's h, well, if you start at a and you move h to the right, you end up at the new x value of a plus h. And that makes our point up here have a height of f of a plus h. So our change in y value is kind of ugly looking now, but it's f of a plus h minus f of a. Change in x is a plus h minus a, but you'll quickly see that those a's just cancel and we just end up with an h. So on the bottom we have just plain h. F of a plus h minus f of a divided by h. And now what limit do we want to take? We were taking the limit as x approached a. So that would be like taking the limit as a plus h approaches a. But that seems kind of silly. How do we make a plus h go to a? We make h go to 0. So as the distance between those two points goes to 0, we'll get the limit value that we want. So let's try this with the same example we just did in the previous video and see how it works. The limit as h goes to 0 of f of a, that's the point we care about, so 1 plus h minus f of 1 divided by h. And f here is still going to be x squared. So the first thing we have to figure out is what is f of 1 plus h? Well, 1 plus h is in the spot where x is supposed to go. So in our equation, where the x is, we're going to put a 1 plus h in parentheses. So our new equation is going to look like limit as h goes to 0 of 1 plus h squared minus 1 squared divided by h. Now again, if we wanted to check our algebra, if we wanted to plug h in here, we would get h becomes 0, so 1 plus 0 squared minus 1 over 0 would be 0 over 0. So it's a 0 over 0 limit, and we need to do some algebra. What should the algebra be? Well, it turns out whenever your function is a polynomial, and x squared is a very simple polynomial, then the algebra is to expand out the top as far as you can. So 1 plus h squared, we FOIL it, we get 1 plus 2h plus h squared minus 1 squared divided by h. And then we ask ourselves, does anything cancel if we do that? And we see that the 1's cancel. And now the next step, whenever you have a polynomial, you FOIL out the top, cancel anything that can cancel, and then you look. And what you should see is an h in every term. So we're going to factor it out. So we're going to have the limit as h goes to 0 of h times, well, 2h, we take out an h, we're left with 2. H squared, we take out an h, we're left with h divided by h. Now that we factored an h out of the top, we're allowed to cancel the h from top and bottom because we have a term of h multiplied by both the top and the bottom. When we cancel the h out of the bottom, we're left with a 1. So now we're looking at the limit as h goes to 0 of 2 plus h divided by 1, which is 2 plus 0 divided by 1, which is 2. So we got the same answer that we got with the other definition, which is good. We expect to hope to get the same answer for solving the same problem. But here, it's taken us a few more steps. We have to plug in for 1 plus h and 1. Then we have to FOIL out the top, cancel anything that matches up. Then we should have an h left in every term. So we pull that h out front. And then we can cancel it with the h in the bottom. Now the bottom will become 1, always. So we just have 2 plus h left on top. As soon as we cancel that h out of top and bottom, that's exactly what was giving us our 0 over 0, because h was going to 0. So we can plug in our h. So h becomes 0. We get 2 plus 0, which is 2. So this might look like it's more difficult for a problem as simple as the slope of x squared when x is 1. But it turns out that when we have really complicated expressions, this formula is going to make the algebra much, much simpler. Because no matter how complicated our polynomial, we can do these exact same steps. And what's more, for other functions, such as rational functions and roots, we can learn one algebra trick and then keep repeating it no matter how complicated those equations are as well.